Hello and welcome to the video series Runtime Analysis for AUTOSAR Embedded Projects. My name is Florian Sommer and I'm responsible for the business development for the product line Embedded Software at Vector Informatik in Stuttgart. In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the timeline as one of the classes of timing analysis that I introduced in the first video of this series. Let's have a look at the timeline itself. We will first of all have a look at how such a timeline looks like and how you can get to such a timeline, and later talk a little bit about the pros and cons of this solution. So here on the bottom, you can see a timeline that you get when you record the task state transitions from your OS. And it's here in this picture compared with pin toggling for the same task, where you toggle a pin whenever the task is activated to the high side, and it's turning to the low side again once the task is terminated. And what you can see here is that you get way more details compared to just pin toggling, because yes, of course, you all also know when the task was activated and you know when it's terminated. But additionally, you get information like preemptions that you can see here in the light green color. So this kind of analysis provides you a way deeper insight into the behavior of your system, and you don't only know when your task was activated and when it was terminated, but you can actually see how often it was preempted, how often other tasks interfered with the task that you are looking at, and this will allow you to make further steps to optimize the system. So let's have a look at how do we get there, how can we actually get such a measurement. First of all, you would need some tooling and also hardware for this approach. So you would need to utilize a trace debugger in order to record such a trace, and then later you can import this trace into the Timing Architects tool suite and use the option inspection in order to analyze it. Prior to recording the scheduling trace, you will also need to configure the trace hooks that are available in the MicroSAR OS, for example, so that the DaVinci configurator offers you the possibility to configure OS hooks that will allow the debugger later to trace the state transitions of your tasks. And if you want to go a level deeper and you also want to know about the different runnables that are executed inside these tasks, then you will need to utilize additionally the VFB hooks that are also available and configurable via the DaVinci configurator. As a next step, you will then need to configure your trace debugger in order to record these state transitions. And afterwards, you can simply import this trace into the Timing Architects tool suite. So what are the positive and negative aspects of this solution? First of all, on the contra side, the downside definitely is that you need additional hardware. So first of all, you need your microcontroller to support such kind of tracing techniques. And this means you will need to have an evaluation device available. Additionally, you will need to consider this when designing your PCB for the ECU, that you also have the interfaces necessary in order to connect your debugger and record the traces. And of course, you will need to have a debugger available in order to do the recordings. So the initial configuration effort, first of all on hardware side, but as well, of course, on the OS side. So you will need to configure the hooks, as I mentioned before, is there. So you have quite some effort compared to other methods that were shown in the previous videos that you need to do in order to get such a result. On the pro side, what's good about that is you have tool support. So you have the DaVinci configurator helping you to configure the OS hooks, and you don't need to instrument them manually in the code. And you have the highest detail level possible because you can not only see statistics or you can only see the activation and termination of the task, but you can see everything that happens in between. So you have very detailed analysis possibilities. You can now also do very detailed runtime analysis on different metrics. So you don't have only the overall runtime. You can also analyze the time your task spent in preemption. You can analyze the netto runtime. You can analyze how often and how regularly a task is triggered. So for example, if you have some periodically scheduled tasks, you want to make sure that this task is really scheduled within its period, so that a 2-millisecond periodic task is really scheduled every 2 milliseconds within a acceptable jitter. And you can also analyze whether this task is keeping a certain runtime, for example. And since you have tool support in this, with that comes also the possibility to automize something like this. So this would mean you would have the possibility, once you have spent the initial configuration effort, you can reuse it over and over again, allowing you to integrate such a solution within your CI system, for example, so that simply with every build, you're automatically recording a trace, you're analyzing a trace, and you can keep constantly track of the different timing requirements and the overall CPU utilization of your system, for example. I was mentioning also that you can even record runnables, that you can analyze different kind of metrics, and you can find out how different tasks interfere with each other, and also that you can automatize this completely. That is going to be part of the next video. At the end of this video, I want to offer you some possibilities to stay in touch and find out more about timing analysis. For that, I'm inviting you to join the LinkedIn group Runtime Analysis in AUTOSAR Projects. In this group, you will meet other people working in this field, sharing their experiences and solutions for this topic. And you will, of course, also be able to engage in discussions and ask your questions there. Just search for the group directly on LinkedIn. Or if you want to have it easier, I put a QR code here in the video so you can simply scan the QR code and you will be redirected to this group. Would be happy to have you in the group. If you have questions to me directly, or if you want to connect with me, I'm inviting you to scan the QR code here on the right. You can also see the link to my profile here on LinkedIn. I would be very happy to connect with you and answer any questions you have. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm looking forward to stay in touch with you.